Hello everyone, welcome back to Punita's Science Fair. Students, in today's video lesson, we are going to learn about control and coordination in humans. Okay? So students, in the previous classes, you all have studied that all living organism is made up of cells. We all know this, right? Every organism is made up of cells. Okay? These cells aggregate and differentiate to form tissues. They get aggregated to form tissues and then they assemble up to form different organs. Clear? And we also know that the various organs perform their function at the right time so that they can work efficiently. And to perform the work efficiently, they are needed a control and coordination. Okay, so let us first understand this point with an example. When we eat food, our eyes help in locating the food, okay? So, whenever we eat food, our eyes locate the food, right? Then, our nose senses the food. The nose help in sensing the food. Then, our hands, they bring the food to our mouth, okay? And our jaw muscles, these help the teeth to chew the food. So all these activities occur in a coordinated manner. And if any of these activities misses or does not occur in time, then the body will not get nutrition. Am I clear? So to perform these all actions, to perform these all activities efficiently, they need a control and coordination. Okay. In case of animal students, including men, okay, including men, the chemical produced by endocrine glands as well as nervous system perform these actions. So in human beings, as I have mentioned you here, in human beings, the control and coordination takes place through the nervous system and the endocrine system, okay, that produce. So this nervous system consists of nerve cells and nerve fibers, whereas endocrine system produce and secrete some hormone, okay. Students, we all know that we have five sense organ in body, okay. These are eyes, ears, nose, tongue and skin. And we call these sense organs receptors, okay. Why receptors? Because they help us in receiving information from the environment around us. So these are called receptors because they receive information from the environment around us. And therefore, the response and coordination in both humans and animals involve the sense organs. So if we summarize the whole thing, we can say now that the whole mechanism involves sense organs, which we call receptors. Then we need a nervous system as well as the endocrine system, or you can say its hormone. Clear? So they all together bring the control and coordination in humans and animals. Am I clear? Okay, fine. Now let's talk about the nervous system. What is nervous system? Students, the nervous system, or you can say the organ system in an animal that serves to coordinate and control the function of all organ system in the body is known as nervous system. Okay. This we have just discussed. So basically, nervous system is an organ system. Okay. Is an organ system which serves to coordinate, which serves to coordinate and control the function of all other organs system in the body. Am I clear? Okay. So now let us look at the points which I have just mentioned you. See, the nervous system consists of nerve fiber and nerve cells. Okay. These nerve cells or nerve fibers transmit impulses, electrical impulses of the nerve between different parts of the body. Okay, so basically this is a system found in animals that synchronizes its function by passing signals. Okay, so they basically synchronizes their function just by passing signals to and fro different part of the body. Okay, likewise it passes information from, you can say that it passes information from one internal system to another. The example which I have just mentioned you is given here. When we put food in mouth, it causes release of saliva from salivary glands. So what actually happened, that impulses was received by salivary glands, which led these glands to produce saliva. Am I clear? So this is how your nervous system functions. Clear? Now let's talk about the types of nervous system. So basically we divide the nervous system into two types, the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. This we will discuss later. Okay. Now let's move to the point which is very, very important. And the point here is the unit of nervous system. This comes in your exam. So this point is very, very important. So neurons are the unit of nervous system. Many a time you get objective question on this particular point. So you just have to keep in consideration that neurons are the unit of nervous system. Clear? Okay. So basically a neuron is a nerve cell. Okay. And this, the structural, you can say that neuron is the structural and functional unit of nervous system. Okay, this point is very important. What actually it do is, it receives and transmits electrical nerve impulses. Okay, and if we talk about the anatomy of neuron, the neuron, or you can say a nerve cell, consists of a cell body. It consists of dendrites, which are, these are the branch finger-like projections. We call them dendrites. An axon is this part. Okay, so this elongated structure is axon. This whole is the cell body, okay? And this cell body usually comprises a nucleus. This finger-like projection is called dendrite. This, the part, jelly-like part, is called stroma, okay? These axons have a Schwann cell, and the nodes are called node of Ranvier. They have a myelin sheath, and these are the axon terminals. And these bulb-like structure are called axon bulb, okay? So basically the electrical impulses, the electrical nerve impulses transmit from the cell body to axon and then to the nerve terminal. Clear? Okay. Now let us talk about the three different type of neurons. So basically the three types of neurons are sensory neurons, okay, motor neurons and relay neurons. What sensory neurons do? They transmit messages from receptors, okay, from receptor. Now you know what receptor is. So they transmit messages from receptors toward the central nervous system, that is the spinal cord and brain. Okay, so basically our central nervous system comprises brain and spinal cord, which we will discuss later. So this is just the basic description. You just have to keep these things in consideration when we will discuss the central nervous system. You will get to know all about in detail. Okay. So what actually happens? The sensory neurons transmit messages from receptors toward the CNS. Okay. Central nervous system, which comprises brain and spinal cord. Clear? The next is motor neuron. It transmits messages from central nervous system toward the muscle cell or effector. Clear? So effectors are the special cells which are made up of some kind of muscles which produces or which perform some basic action. Okay. According to the stimuli they receive. And relay neurons serve as the link. They serve as the link between other neurons. So they serve as the linkers. Okay. They are present in the central nervous system. So these are found to be present in CNS. They are associated with central nervous system. And these neurons have this specific function. Okay. Students, I'm explaining you the whole process which I have just shown you here. The process of the electrical nerve impulses, how it get transmitted. So what actually happened, the cell body of a neuron of the cell body of a neuron contains cytoplasm and a nucleus, as you see in the picture. Okay, there are many long thin fibers coming out of the cell body of a neuron. Okay, these short fibers or finger-like projection are called dendrites, which I have just mentioned to you. Clear? So, and the long fiber which you see, this long fiber is axon. Okay, so this long fiber is axon. Clear? The axon is covered with an insulating and protective sheath called myelin sheath. It is basically made of fat and proteins. So the sheath is actually made up of protein and fat. Fat and protein. Clear? Okay. The messages transmitted through nervous system is in the form of electrical impulses. This I have shown you here. Okay. So basically what actually happened, the dendrites pick the nerve impulses or messages from receptors. Okay. And send them to cell body and then to axon. And the axon send these impulses to another neuron through a junction called synapse. So here basically they have another neuron, but they make a cleft here which we call synaptic cleft. Okay, there is a gap, there is a junction, that junction is called synapse. But between those two neurons there is a cleft, and that cleft is called synaptic cleft. So this is how electric impulses, or you can say the electric signals, transmitted to one neuron to another. Clear? Okay. So now let's talk about the parts of nervous system. So as I have just mentioned you before, that the nervous system is divided into two parts. The first is central nervous system and the second is peripheral nervous system. So let us first take this one, central nervous system. So basically this consists of brain and spinal cord. Okay. So central nervous system comprises brain and spinal cord. We generally call CNS or central nervous system as thinker. Okay. Or you can also say information processor. Clear? In the body. So basically we call them information processor because most of the information being transmitted because of the neurons. Okay. And this takes place in the central nervous system. Now, if we talk about the peripheral nervous system, which we denoted as CNS, okay, it includes sensory and motor nerves. So, it includes sensory and motor nerve, okay, and it connects the central nervous system with the sense organs, muscles and glands of the body. So, this CNS is regarded as actor or performer. This act as actor, we call them actor or you can say performer. Why? Because the sensory and motor nerves which was associated in peripheral nervous system, the PNS has association of sensory and motor nerves, and it connects the central nervous system with the sense organs, muscles and gland of the body. Okay, and that is why we call them performer or actor. Clear? So in the next video, students, we will discuss this chapter. This whole point is very vast. It can't be completed in one lecture. So in the next lecture, in the next video lecture, we will discuss for CNS in detail, and then we will discuss peripheral nervous system. Okay? I hope today's topic is clear to you all. And in the next video, we will talk about central nervous system. Okay? Till then, take care. Goodbye.